kind of funny that a lot of people don't even know that this is here. They'll say, there's a nuclear reactor on campus. I'm like, have you never noticed the blue dome with the brick chimney? And they're like, oh, that's what that is? It looks like a water tank, but it's not a tank of water, it's a tank of science.
You can see behind us, there's some stuff coming out. We just want to clarify it. That's not smoke, it's not radioactive.
It's water vapor, and it's totally safe for the environment, and it's just how they cool the reactor.
I'm a six-year now PhD candidate. I work here on Albany Street in a bunch of the labs we're going to be seeing.
And I'm a fifth-year grad student. I work in a lot of the same labs as Brandon and a few different ones.
After you. I think the overarching goal of a lot of the labs on Albany Street is climate change and attacking it in different ways.
We need to understand more about the energy we're using because, like, we're going to get to a point where we don't have energy anymore, and that is a problem. The easy thing to do to create energy was to burn things with fire. That was easy, but it turns out burning things isn't the ideal way to get electricity on the grid. So we've done that. We did the easy thing, and now we need to do the hard thing.
We're going to see the fission reactor, then we're going to go on to an accelerator lab. We're going to see lasers, electron microscopes, nanoparticle labs.
Bubbles.
We're going to see a fusion experiment.
Plasma experiments.
Corrosion labs.
Lots of magnets.
Like any cool science word you can think of, like, we have it on this street.
Down to the basement labs.
What a real fun.
We both study fusion energy.
Fusion is really cool because it could be a baseload form of power, and the fuel source you can get from water, like from seawater. So we have literally millions of years worth of fuel if we can get fusion to work.
One of the things that really gets me excited about fusion and fission and nuclear energy in general is the forms of energy we use now are breaking chemical bonds. Nuclear energy is kind of like the next step forward in technology because we're breaking atomic bonds and reforming atomic bonds, and it's really the next step forward for society and science.
I don't know anywhere else really in the world where you have this wide array of all these different tools that are literally located all just down the span of like 2,000 feet down one street.
Pop it in there, load it in.
I can take my samples that came out of the reactor and walk down the hall. I don't have to go outside on the street because there's all these protocols you have to follow, you know, about the transport of radioactive material. I can take all of my material that's radioactive within this building to, like, this facility, for example, work on it. I can take it down to the accelerator lab and work on it. And so normally, experiments like this would take a really long time and involve a lot of paperwork and a lot of money. And here, we can kind of just do everything in-house and really, really quickly, which is great. We end up working in a lot of these labs.
Yeah, we haven't worked in every single one, but we at least work with people who use them. And even if you don't work with the equipment in the lab, there's a lot of times where you'll need to just go talk to somebody in that lab because they know about some aspect of the research you're doing.
Yeah.
So it's about the stuff in the labs, but it's also about the people that we work with and how we share information and learn how to do the things that we do.
Can I draw the triangle?
Yeah.
It's pretty cool being here. It's almost like working at a little miniature national lab, except it's at a university instead. And we're friends with everybody there.
There are electricians and welders and machinists on the street that can do things that, like, I don't know where else you would find it all in the same place. Where you can be like, I need this thing welded for vacuum and also this electricity that has a ridiculous amperage that nobody else would ever need. Like,
you'd be like, oh yeah, we can do that.
Yeah.
Probably 1,000 people on the street with expertise in everything related to nuclear and energy and engineering and machining and electrical, like everything.
So my analogy that you're gonna laugh at, Leanne, is in Game of Thrones, where people are fighting these like tiny little battles, and then like off in the north somewhere, there's like these weird dudes who hang out on a wall that are like warning everybody that this like really, really bad thing is gonna happen.
We need the dragons. Is that what you're saying, Brandon?
We need the dragons. We need the fusion dragon.
Yeah. It's a good analogy.